So what could result in complications? We need to understand that before to know how to avoid it. The choice of filler is very important, and this is related to the hypersensitivity complications. And by now we have decided or chosen a few fillers that never really gives us any problem. The injection technique should be slow and very gentle, as I'm going to show you. And the injection device, whether a needle or a cannula, and definitely using a cannula, not just any cannula. It should be from a good manufacturer, because a blunt cannula can also be traumatic. It shouldn't be less than 25 gauge, because thinner cannulas can act like needles and give us the same problems. So I'll talk about all of these in detail, and I'll show some videos showing the technique. Looking at the cannula, as you see, a very smooth tipped cannula can save us of problems. The bruising, the early swelling, and the pigmentation that results from the bruises as they resolve have really almost been eliminated with the use of cannulas. We have not seen any of these recently, over the past 5 years really. This is what I mean by recently. And the inflammatory and the hypersensitivity reactions, we really overcome that by just experience and choosing the right filler. It should be a low G prime filler that doesn't give a lot of elevation in this area. And we found that fillers designed and dedicated for the tear trough area, and actually fillers that are designed for the lips also, because they are quite smooth fillers, gave us excellent results regarding the inflammatory reaction that we're showing in this picture.